In this video, I'll show you how to install CHDK on your Canon camera. CHDK stands for Canon Hack Development Kit. This will allow you to unlock a plethora of hidden features on your camera, including scripts for time-lapse photography and increasing the exposure time well beyond the factory default of 15 seconds. Of course, there's a lot more than that you can do, but those are the two things that I think are really cool. Don't worry, it's not a permanent hack. You can quickly and easily revert back to the factory defaults by turning the camera off and back on again. If you already know what CHDK is, click here to skip ahead. Unlocking these extra features in your camera is possible through the Canon Hack Development Kit. Basically, this is a group of really cool open source hackers that share their code with everybody else. I discovered CHDK shortly after I bought my Canon PowerShot SX30IS. That's the camera I'll be using in this demonstration. Before we begin, here are some of the cool features you'll be able to access. Shooting in RAW, shutter, aperture, and ISO overrides, using long shutter speeds up to 64 seconds and sometimes much longer depending on your camera, ultra-fast shutter speeds, like 1/10,000th of a second and sometimes much faster, customizable high-speed continuous burst, focus bracketing, script execution, including intervalometer time-lapse scripts, motion detection triggering, fast enough to capture lightning, USB cable remote shutter release. And that's just the beginning. There's many more features. There are two methods for installing CHDK on your camera. Method 1 is the card lock boot method. This will load CHDK automatically from your memory card every time you turn on your camera. Or method 2, the firmware update method, which I will be outlining in this tutorial. You'll need a Canon camera, an SD memory card, an SD card reader, and a Mac or a PC. Step 1. Format your SD memory card. Make sure you take all your pictures off first, as they will be erased. Place the memory card in your camera. Turn on the camera. Hit the menu button. Scroll over to camera settings. Scroll down to format. Hit enter. Hit OK. Step 2. Determine what firmware version is installed on your camera. Create a blank text file named ver.req or vers.req. You can do this on a PC using Notepad or on a Mac using TextEdit. Both of those programs should already be loaded on your computer. Take the memory card out of your camera and put it in your computer or card reader.
Okay, so if you have a Mac, find the program TextEdit, open it up, go to Preferences. Now this is important. You want to make sure encoding is set to Unicode UTF-8. If you don't do that, you'll have problems making this work. Alright, so now that we change that, we go to Save As, and let's name that file ver.req and hit save. There we go, the file popped up on the desktop. And right click, hit get info. And another very important part, you need to change that extension from rich text format, delete that, just make it .req. Going to ask you if you really want to do it, say yes. .req is crucial. And now you just got to drag and drop into the root directory of the SD memory card. And bingo, there it is, Unix executable file. All right, all you PC users out there, open up Notepad, hit File, Save As. You're going to name that file ver.req. Click All Files, Save As Type All Files, again change it to UTF-8, hit Save. There's our file. And all you gotta do is drag and drop into the root directory of your SD memory card. And there we go.
Safely eject the SD memory card, put the SD memory card back into the camera, turn on the camera, and put it into play mode for viewing pictures. Hold the function set button and tap the display button at the same time. Write down the number that appears next to firmware ver. This is your firmware version. It should look similar to this, 1.00n. Don't worry about the letter before or the numbers in parentheses afterwards. We're not concerned with those. Turn off the camera, take out the SD memory card, and place it back into the computer or SD card reader. Step 3, download the CHDK zip file that matches your camera's model number and the firmware version. You can find that online by going to this website,
http://might-hoernsche.de.
Scroll down until you see your camera's model number. Download the zip file associated with your firmware version. You'll notice that you have a choice between small and complete. The small version has only the files you'll need to run CHDK. The complete version has extra stuff like scripts, languages, and extra files. Step 4. Unzip the CHDK zip file.
Mac users, the default archive utility that comes standard with your OS will not work. Head over to stuffit.com and download the free Stuffit Expander application and install it. Once Stuffit Expander is installed, right-click the CHDK zip file, click Open With, select Other, select Stuffit Expander from the list, click Open. PC users, there's no need to download any extra application. Simply right-click the CHDK zip file, select Extract All, click Extract.
When the folder has been unzipped, you should see 5 files in one folder. Step 5. Drag and drop all of these files and folders into the root directory of your SD memory card. You'll need to verify that a file named ps.fi2 is present in the root directory. If that file is not there, I'm sorry to say you're out of luck. That means CHDK has not yet been developed for your firmware version. Step 6. Safely eject your SD memory card from your computer and place it in your camera. Okay guys, we're getting to the fun part. Steps 7, 8, 9, and 10 will be your standard procedure for turning on CHDK via the firmware update. So here we go. Step 7. Turn on the camera by pressing the play button for viewing pictures. This is very important, and CHDK will not work if you turn on the camera using the standard on-off button. You need to turn on the camera using the play mode button. Step 8. Hit the menu button. Scroll all the way down to Firm Update. Press Function Set, then OK. You will see a CHDK startup screen appear briefly on your camera's display. That means you did it. Step 9. Tap the shutter button lightly to switch back into camera mode. You should notice some extra features on your camera's display, like the exact percentage of battery life. Step 10. Press the shortcut Alt button to toggle between CHDK mode and regular mode. Once you're in CHDK mode, you'll notice a blinking in the lower left corner of your display. The menu button will now bring you to a different menu with many more options. The Function Set button will also bring you to a new menu that will allow you to load scripts and change the parameters of those scripts. To get back to your camera's default settings, you can simply hit the shortcut Alt button or turn the camera off and back on again. Now you've got CHDK successfully installed on your camera's SD memory card. To load CHDK again in the future, simply repeat steps 7 through 10 to initiate the firmware update method. Tune in next Friday for another video tutorial about how to load and run a popular time-lapse script called Countdown Intervalometer. If you ever want to load CHDK again, all you have to do is repeat steps 7 through 10. Really? People don't know how to drive. Tune in next Friday for a video tutorial of how to load and run a popular time-lapse script called Countdown Intervalometer. Intervalometer.
And bologna sandwich.